Hi everyone, this is Asim from Trade with Asim and Sajjad, and today I'm here to give you weekly analysis for 30th July to 3 August 2018. Before I start my analysis, I would ask everyone, those who have joined just recently or are just watching the video for the first time, kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can get all the updates that we are posting on. Apart from our analysis, we have got our website in which we post technical analysis, we post the videos, we have got best brokers, live charts, economic calendar and educational section in which we upload PDF books regularly. So it's a broad platform. We have got the top recommended brokers on our website, starting from Exim to CFD Global, Noor Capital, followed by Amana Capital and Pepperstone. So I would start my weekly analysis by the economic calendar. As you can see, on Monday 30th July, we don't have any important news rather than the pending house sales, pending home sales, MOM from the US, and the other ones are from Japanese yen. We might see some news from Eurozone as well as from Swiss. Moving on to Tuesday 13th, we have got some news from Australian dollar, Japanese yen, Eurozone. The most important is CPI from the Europe, unemployment rate as well, and GDP for the USD Canadian dollar is really important on Tuesday. It will have a great impact on the pair of USD Canadian dollar and other CAD pairs. Consumer confidence in July, for the month of July, on Tuesday is also really important. Employment change in New Zealand is also really important news. Going through August 1st, we got German manufacturing PMI, which is really great for European Eurozone and European EU currency. Non-farm payroll is a very important event in every month and the start of month, which is on the 1st of August this month. So we will have also an OPEC meeting. And crude oil inventory will be declared on Wednesday, 1st August. Thursday, we have got some news from Britain. There will be interest decision for August. Board BOE will speak. Not much really on Friday. As you can see, there will be some imports and non-farm payroll in the US. There will be private non-farm payrolls as well, unemployment rate as well. All of the predictions are here. If you wish to see, you can visit our website, tradewithasimandsajjad.com, and click on economic calendar. Now moving on to our weekly analysis, starting from the dollar index. As you can see, last week finished with a dodgy candle, and if it's a dodgy candle, I would expect in Hikanashi that the next one is going to be a green candle. But on the other side, it's going to be a very, very tricky week as it's currently at the resistance level of 94.52, and it will try to go below, as it tried below, but it got bounced back in 3 weeks. It bounced back from EMA 200. So the most chances are once again that in this week, it will go again and try to approach 95.5 or maximum 96 points. Technically, it's already above 75, and currently it's trading on 87 points. So I would expect that it will drop. Currently, as we can see, Hikanashi candlestick, and we have also drawn our Fibonacci retracement. So it's in the same channel between 93.86 to 95.63, and it has been trading during this range from last few weeks. So I would speculate that, as per my experience with Hikanashi candlestick, when the closure of the candle is done in doji, as you can see here, the next candle is expected to be red. But if we see in a technical way, we are expected to be dropping it soon. I'll just change on the weekly basis my candlestick pattern from Hikanashi to normal candles. As we can see, it's again trying to go up from that level. So it's going to be really tricky. but I would say that it will drop. But if it drops from 93.86 points, we expect it to be down to 92.76 and further below. So that's all for the dollar index. I'm expecting it to be bearish, but as per Hacken Ashi, it can be technically it's bearish. But as per my Hacken Ashi experience with the candle pattern of Hacken Ashi, it might go up in the middle and then come back down. So we need to see how the Monday will go. But overall, I can see that the trend might go up. So the trend will be bullish and will try once again to achieve 96 points for dollar index. Moving on to Euro USD. It's also a doji candle and it's a normal candlestick. I will just change my plot setting to Hacken Ashi. Sorry, it's already Hacken Ashi. I'll change it to a candlestick. So we can see on candlestick, the weekly chart closed towards downward, meaning that it's below the pivot. So as per the pivot, I would expect that the candle will move towards the downward direction, and I'm expecting a bearish momentum. There are some really important news coming from in the market from the US throughout the week, so we expect a bearish momentum. But I would tell you one thing, that whenever there is, everybody is saying it's going to be bearish, it's always going to be a bullish momentum as well. So we need to take care of it, and you need to also watch our daily analysis, as if it keeps on changing, we will also update you on daily basis. I will once again change to Hacken Ashi. As you can see, the candle got closed at the same level of opening, actually, the one in which the market opened. It's a very tricky one. It's in blue. I'm expecting a red candle approaching towards 1.159, and then further is 1.150. It's a very strong support here, which is at 1.150, and I expect that it will try to approach within this week, and the overall momentum will remain bearish. Moving on to GBP USD on a weekly pattern, we will just check our plot setting as it's at Hacken Ashi. Currently, it's a downtrend also for GBP USD, and it's trying to go. It's a very strong trend, as you can see from the top. It's been coming on continuously. It is coming on towards a downtrend, and it has just closed below the pivot, which is at 1.313, and I expect that this will try to approach once again at a very good support level of 1.298. Breaching through this support will expect another level of support 2, which is at 1.280. So I'm expecting and speculating that this trend might move towards a downward, as well as it's a bearish momentum for this pair as well throughout the whole week. I'll just check the candle, the pattern on a normal candlestick pattern. As you can see, it's also a red candle and it's closing below the pivot. So any candle close for the weekly or the daily chart, it's close in the below the pivot, we expect that the momentum is going towards the same direction. So I'm speculating that it will try to approach support 1 and will try to breach support 1 and will go further and approach and will try to achieve actually support 2 level at 1.280. So that's all for GBP USD. A very great pair, a very good momentum towards downwards. So it's a very good sell from so many times, as the pound is weak and the dollar is not really great, but still it's getting benefit from the dollar, from the British pound being weaker. Moving on to USD CAD, as we can see, due to the oil inventories, we saw a big spike last week. And it tried to approach, it tried to break the support at 1.301, but it failed actually and bounced back from that level and did some very good retracement. Currently, it's below the pivot, which is quite unlikely that it has closed below pivot. So if it has broken its trend, or it has broken its correlation with the dollar index, It might go as the dollar is US Canadian dollar is getting stronger day by day, and we do expect some good oil inventories as the oil price might have a very good hike. The more the oil price is had a hike, we can expect the Canadian dollar getting stronger. I'm expecting a bullish momentum as it has been close below the pivot, which is and currently trading at support one, which is at 1.309. We would expect it's kind of a sideways market in this one, but still I would expect a bearish momentum and we'll try to breach the support 2 at 1.301. Once again, if we have a strong data from the Canadian, it might breach once again 1.291. Being a technical and fundamental weekly analysis, we have to keep in mind that we have to look at the news coming in and all the political impact and geological impacts in the region as well. So USD CAD, I'm speculating that it will be a bearish momentum. USD Japanese yen. Once again, it's a very strange situation in all of the currencies as the correlation has been broken. Most of the currencies are getting weaker, and the dollar being at a weaker point, but still it's going high, the dollar index. Other currencies are getting stronger as well against, and that strength is more than the US dollar strength. So Japanese yen is currently trying to breach support one at 110.832, and it will drop towards downward. I expect a good drop in this pair as it has closed below the pivot. We might see some retracement in the start of the week on Monday. It will try to go up, but overall I can see that the pair will be going towards a downward direction, as being a lot of news few news coming from Japan, and we expect that those news will be good for Japanese yen. Moving on to Swiss franc and US dollar. Swiss franc against the US dollar is quite tricky. The Swiss franc is strong, and it is just in the middle. I would call for a caution for this pair as it's in the middle. It closed its candle with a green candle, and I will see what's the plot setting for this one. If it's a Heikinashi, it's a normal candlestick. I'll just check with Heikinashi. After the doji candle, again red doji candle, I can expect that it might go upward, but the market might go sideways as the US dollar has been continuously growing. So if the dollar index grow, I'm expecting this to break above the pivot and will try to approach resistance at 1.004. so I'm speculating that it will approach, but being at a very strong level, I would look for a longer term, as it had dropped in so many times from this level as well. So I would be in terms of the history, I would say that it might drop from this level, but further on as the US dollar getting strengthened, I'm expecting it to approach 1.004. Further on, alternative would be if it keeps on below on Monday and Tuesday, if it keeps itself below the pivot, which is a 0.998, I'm expecting it to breach support 1 at 0.991 and support 2 at 0.985. Moving on to Australian and US dollar, it's closed above the pivot. In fact, it's currently trading above the pivot, as I will just take you closer for a closer look further on. Australian dollar is kind of getting stronger as well, but not as stronger as the US dollar. As you can see, the trend overall is downward trend. It has been last couple of weeks, it has been in the same channel between 0.747 and 0.739. I would expect the same way, but this time I would be expecting that it will drop below 0.734. most probably the drop will start from Tuesday, as there will be not really great movement on Monday. So I will expect that it will have a bearish momentum as it's currently just above the pivot, but we would expect that it will break that level and try to approach support one at 0.734. Moving on to New Zealand and US dollar. New Zealand dollar is trying to recover against the dollar, but it's unable to recover, and the pair is going towards downward. It has got the same position like Australian dollar. I would say if the Australian dollar and the New Zealand dollar, they always move in similar direction. If you compare the charts, we can see some similarities as well. I expect a downward, and it will try to approach 0.674. Moving on to gold, one of the really great pair that me and Sajjad are always trading. I'm expecting the dollar being a stronger, and we can see a strong downtrend. I would speculate that it will try to break this pivot at 1.1233, and it will try to reach once again 1210 if it breaks below, as the support is really strong at this level, which might not happen as the dollar is not gonna get really stronger, as it will approach 1210, and I would expect it to buy from that level and close and put the TP around 1232 or 1220. So gold is bearish, but not that much bearish, as the trend is really bouncing back from this level, and it has bounced back so many times from this level. So I'm speculating based on that one that we might not see gold going too much down. It will stay and will try to remain between 1200 points or 12 1200 and 1232 during the week, and getting the dollar, the gold might get stronger as well. But it completely depends on how the Monday and Tuesday goes, because technically the dollar index is going to drop as well. So we will see how it moves on Monday as well, and we will keeping you update about the dollar index and how the dollar is moving, and how the other pairs may change its movement with the respect of time. That's all from Trade with Asim and Sajjad. I wish you like our analysis, and you are watching it till the end. If you like our analysis, I would like you to share our video with your friends and colleagues, so that they can also get a very great knowledge that we are sharing with you guys. And we do work really hard in order to record these analysis. So expect you to share, like, and give us a thumbs up if it was really amazing.